गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश बाल भारती क्लास. चिल्ड्रन, टुडे विल बी डूइंग पार्ट टू ऑफ द चैप्टर विच इज 2.4, थ्री विजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन हाफ ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इन आर पार्ट वन वीडियो एंड दिस वीडियो इज योर पार्ट टू. सो हियर वी आर स्टार्टिंग the part 2 with why are we in India so embarrassed to recognize our own strength, our own achievements. We are such a great nation. We have so many amazing success stories, but we refuse to acknowledge them. Why? We are second largest producer of wheat in the world. We are second largest producer of rice. We are the first in milk production. We are number one in remote sensing satellites. Yes, what the writer is trying to say over here, APJ Abdul Kalam is trying to say that why are we in India so embarrassed? Here, embarrassed means why are we always feeling shy or ashamed to recognize our own strength, my dear children? Why don't we understand that we are not less than other countries? Then why are we so obsessed with the foreign things and not the product of our countries, not the achievements of our own country, that is India? We are such a great nation. We have so many amazing stories. Yes, even our country has amazing stories, my dear children, but we refuse to admit them. We refuse to acknowledge them. Now, what do you mean by acknowledge? Acknowledge them means we don't give much importance to those stories. Why? We are the second largest producer of wheat. Yes, we know that India is the second largest producer of wheat. We are the second largest producer of rice. We are the first in milk production. We are so well versed with agriculture, with the milk production. So why don't we acknowledge our achievements? Why don't we admit that we are in this position? We are number one in remote sensing satellite. Yes, this is really a great thing. Don't you think so, children? So we are number one in remote sensing satellites. Remote sensing satellites means man-made satellites which are launched into space for communication. I hope you are getting it. So for communication, like video calls, we can come live, you know, when we are making video calls, we can come live and see each other. We can talk to the person who is sitting outside the country. So all this is possible with the help of remote sensing satellite, which means man-made satellites. You might have studied this in geography also, my dear children. So why are we not understanding and recognizing all these achievements which India has achieved? Like Dr. Abdul Kalam has told in the part one, his three visions for India. One is obviously he wants the India to be free, right? That is a free nation. He wants us to be developed. And the third vision was to standing up. That's what Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is trying to say that way. Why we are not acknowledging such great things that our country has achieved? Further, look at Dr. Sudarshan. He has transferred the tribal village into the self-sustaining, self-driving unit. Now over here, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is giving the example in the lecture that look at proper suggestion he has transferred. He has transformed a tribal village, a tribal village where the scheduled tribes people used to stay. That tribal village is now converted into self-sustaining. Now, what do you mean by self-sustaining, children? Self-sustaining means a village which can provide its own needs. It can fulfill its own needs, okay? Self-deriving unit. They are not dependent on anyone else. They are able to control the needs within their zone. So that is how a tribal village is transformed into self-sustaining and self-driving unit by Dr. Sudarshan. There are millions of such achievement students. It's not just Dr. Sudarshan. And there are millions of such achievements. But our media, our TV channels, our news channel are just obsessed with bad news. Here, obsessed means they are interested in just showing the bad news. They don't want to show good news. Like, they don't want to appreciate the work done by Dr. Sudarshan. They will never appreciate and, you know, bring up such good news. And there are millions of such achievement. But our media, our TV channels, our news channel are just obsessed with bad news, as I told you. Yes, who can understand this better than us right now in the situation in which we are? The news channel are just obsessed with one particular news. We are just so much interested with the bad news and failures and disaster all around. From where will positivity will come? From where will we learn positive things? Because all the time, my dear children, we are just surrounded by those bad news. We are full of failures and disasters and all the bad news. But this is something we should understand, that we should find the positivity into the things. So that if we find the positivity, they'll bring out the positivity around us. Children, it's natural. When throughout the day, throughout the time, you hear bad news, of course, you become sad. You have a sad emotion. And when you hear good things, automatically you rejoice, you enjoy that day. Of course, that's a human tendency. Our surrounding, our atmosphere has an effect on us. So that's what Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is trying to say. So that's what he is saying, that there are millions of achievement. Then why are we just obsessed with the bad things? Why are we interested only in showing the bad things? Why don't we turn to the good things? Going to the next para, children. Do we not realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance? Now, what is self-reliance, students? Self-reliance means to be self-dependent. What a beautiful line that has been told by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He said that, why are we not realizing that we will get self-respect only by being self-dependent or self-reliance? Unless and until we are not self-dependent, then how we will self-respect us? So in order to self-respect own self, we need to be self-dependent first, my dear children. You should not be dependent on others for small things. And that is what Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is saying, that our country has achieved so many things in the field of science, literature, economy, and many more sports field. We have achieved many things in so many years. Then why are we not obsessed with our own achievements? Moving ahead. I was in Tel Aviv once and I was reading the Israeli newspaper. It was the day after a lot of attacks and the bombardments. What do you mean by bombardment, students? Bombardment is nothing but a continuous attack with bomb. Like, children, I'll give you one example. Imagine as usual, in the morning you woke up and one morning you woke up and went out for a walk. There you saw one gentleman planting a plant in his garden. And on the other side, you see that there's some kind of blast happening. Now you say me, what thing you would like to see first in the morning after getting up? A person who's planting in his garden, or the blast and the deaths of the people and the bloodshed everywhere? No, obviously. You won't like to see the bombardment. Instead, you will love to see the same plant giving beautiful flowers. Am I right, children? Yes, no one will like this. But there were so many attacks that had happened. But the front page news of the newspaper had a picture of Jewish gentleman who in 5 years had transformed his desert land into an orchard farm and granary. He turned a big desert land into orchard farm and granary, my dear children. And that was there on the front page in the newspaper. Imagine, after having so much of bombardment that day, but still the newspaper front page news was not about the bombardment. In fact, it was about this Jewish gentleman who turned the desert into an orchard farm and granary in the period of 5 years. And this news was on the front page in the newspaper. Now you say, on the front of the newspaper, on the front page of the newspaper, when you see such positive news in the morning while sipping your tea or a coffee, so obviously your day will be positive. Don't you think so, children? But what we see in our newspapers, that this person has killed that person, or here many people have been dead, or there this COVID-19 is doing this, or this is the effect of the COVID-19, the police have caught that person for that particular crime, blah 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 blah. So we start our day with so much of negativity, but that is not the case in the Israeli newspaper, my dear children. That is what the example Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam has shared. It was this inspiring picture that everyone woke up to by seeing that the Jewish gentleman has turned the desert land into an orchard farm. Everyone was sipping their coffee or the tea with such an inspiring picture. The gory details of killing, here gory detail means the bloodshed, violence. So all those details of killings were also there. No doubt, even that bombardment news were there. Even the attack which has happened on Hamas was also there. But all these news were there inside the newspaper, my dear children. And about which newspaper we are talking? We are talking about Israeli newspaper. After suffering so much, after getting that bombardment, after the attack on the Hamas, still the news were not on the front page. That means that they don't want to horrify the people early in the morning. They don't want to spoil the mood of the people. Yes, because fresh morning means fresh start, and our morning must be very fresh, full of positivity. So he's saying that these news were there in the newspaper, no doubt, but it was buried somewhere inside the newspaper and not on the front page. It was inside, on maybe in the middle or the back pages of the newspaper. The details of the killings, the bombardments, the death were all inside the newspaper, buried among other news. Isn't it possible in our country? I mean, can't our country's newspaper do this? Can't they put the bad news in the back or in the middle page, and can't they print the front page with the positive news? What do you think on this, children? Think on it. Yes, student, keeping this all aside, can't we focus on important things like the farmers are dying, the climatic change is happening, the GDP is falling? Why are we not focusing on that? And why are we focusing on such rubbish news? What has happened has already happened, children. We can't change that. Then why to crib on that? Why to cry on that? That's what I feel so. I know even you might be feeling the same, my dear children. So again, I'm asking, isn't this possible in our country? The media should be obsessed with all the positive news rather than all the bad news, because people actually look to media. We people see media. We people follow media. Now you just tell me, in this lockdown period, what we were doing? We were just watching and updating ourselves on news and on mobile updates. Didn't we do that? Yes, we did. And what did we get to see everywhere? Just the news about COVID-19 pandemic. All that bad news. Was there any good positive news in that period? No, my dear children. In fact, even today we are seeing the same. So can't we change this pattern of, you know, keeping all the bad news aside and talking on some good things for the development of our country? So that was about the para. Moving to the last para. I want to live in a developed India, says Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Another question, my dear children, that Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is throwing on us is, why are we as a nation so obsessed with foreign things? We want foreign TVs, we want foreign shirts, we want foreign technology. He's correct, students. Even I do agree with him. We are so much obsessed with the imported things. If we want to buy clothes, we go for foreign brands. The brands, the apps, everything. We go for the imported ones. Am I right? Yes. You see, majority of the people, you'll see very less number of people going for Indian brand. We are all obsessed and addicted towards foreign brand. We don't like the product of our country. We have started adapting over the foreign brands. And because of this, you know what is happening, my dear children? Our country's economy, that is money, is going outside India. And that's the reason our GDP is falling. There is poverty in our country. And our economy is actually falling because of this. Why this obsession with everything imported? Why are we so much addicted with imported things? Why do we have so much of obsession with the foreign products? Doesn't brand like Patanjali sort our day-to-day problems? Yes, I think it can fulfill our needs, the brand like Patanjali. Apart from Patanjali, there are also few Indian brands in our market, in our Indian market. But we never turn on those brands. We never try to, you know, I mean, we don't take initiative to try that. We are so addicted with those foreign branded things. Do we not realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance? Again, to prove this, Dr. APJ says, can we understand that self-respect comes with self-reliance? Okay. Now, here I was telling you, what do you mean by imported things? Imported means the things which are bought from abroad, from other country. That is from abroad. And self-reliance means to be self-dependent, like I told you in the previous paragraph also. So children, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is saying that, why are we not able to realize that self-respect will only come with self-reliance? If you are self-dependent, every country, every person is going to come and ask you. Your self-respect will never be ruined. It will be never decrease. So by self-reliance, you get self-respect, and by self-respect, you get self-reliance. That is vice versa, I mean opposite. Further, he says, I was in Hyderabad giving this lecture. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is saying that I was in Hyderabad giving this lecture when a 14-year-old girl. What was the age of the girl, my dear students? 14-year-old girl. A 14-year-old girl means, I guess she might be in 8 or 9 standard like you people, my dear students. So just a 14-year-old girl asked me, here me means Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, for his autograph. And I asked her, that is, afterward, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam asked her, what is her goal in life? What is her goal in life? Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam asked her, what is her goal in life? And you know, students, what did she reply? She replied, I want to live in a developed India where we are not dependent on other countries. So Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam says, for making this type of India, I want your promise, children. Let's take an oath together. Let's proclaim together that for her, for that 14-year-old girl, you and I will build this developed India. We will build this developed India. We are not dependent on others. We will be self-reliant and we won't be obsessed with the foreign products. We will love our own products, our own technology, our own things, instead of buying and being addicted over the imported brands. So for her, you and I together will have to build this developed India. You must proclaim. Now, what does proclaim means, my dear students? Proclaim means to declare confidently to all that yes, we will make this developed India. Or in other words, I can say, hum honge kamyab. So let's take a oath together that we will make such developed India. And how can be this possible? When we will boycott these foreign products. If we will boycott these foreign products, we will start using our Indian products. And what will happen? We'll become self-dependent. The economy will come in our own country and we will not be dependent on other country for any sort of power. We ourselves will be very contented. So that was I wanted to conclude. So let's take a oath together that we will make such developed India. So Jai Hind, my dear children. And I love my country. I hope you all do so. So with this, my dear students, we are done with the part 2 of this lesson, that is three vision for India. And we have also completed this chapter. I hope you have followed it thoroughly. Okay. So till then, do take care of yourself and try to boycott these products and try to get adapt with the Indian products. Try to be self-dependent. Do not be dependent on small things on others. And try to make our India a developed one, a developed nation. With this, I would like to take your leave. Take care. Till then. Okay. Goodbye. Thank you.